right from the get-go, the question we all posed is, how do we make this better? How do we do it differently? Let's throw out everything and start over. And we had all these great ideas. The gameplay in Uncharted was much more, in Uncharted 4 was much more dynamic. So we had this stealth action component that we'd never had before. The setups that these stealth action events happened in were more open. They were like big fish bowls instead of these linear paths that you had to go through. You could solve these things different ways. You could stealth through a whole fight. So we started looking at the AI states, and this is where the real story is, because they had all these lofty goals for the AI in the game right from the beginning, and they were gonna have 6+ states that they could be in at any point in time, and we'd have an aggregate value of that that we could tap into. Then I wanted to push it a bit further, and I spent all this time, and I actually talked about this the last time I was here, if anybody saw that talk in 2015. I've had this fantasy for a long time of getting more in an action game, of getting more like an action movie. And when I watch a lot of action movies, I think about the angularity of the music in that, right? And they have the advantage of knowing from cut to cut what's gonna happen. So the hero runs down a hallway and there's a cool groove going and he stops at a corner and everything drops out and there's like high string tension, and then he looks around the corner and some element comes in and then he jumps out of cover and we go back to, you know, the groove or whatever. And so the direction I gave to our team was, when something happens, do something. And they did it. So that really sums up like how we came up with the system. And I'll show you how it worked, or didn't. So we had, we decided to take all the percussion and attach it to what I just described. So basically we're taking a big risk, because something we try to avoid, which is you as a player making things happen in the music in a very direct way, by say taking cover or leaving cover or looking down the sights of your gun. And we decided to go with that. We decided to give the player more agency in the interactivity of the music. But at the same time, we had the AI driving the rest of the music. So the percussion and the groove elements are tied to all these player-driven events. The rest of the music is reacting to what's happening in the AI. So these are the AI states. I don't know if you can read that, but it says like unaware on the left, search, combat. And this is, you know, live recorded, big, bold orchestral music. So we cut it up into the smallest chunks possible. These are usually like 8 or 16 bars of music. And then we also have to have transitions that work between the different states. If you've ever tried making interactive music, it's really easy to go up in intensity because you're interrupting something kind of mellow. So you do it on a bar line, it sounds good. Getting back down is super difficult, right? Because the bottom just falls out. So we have all these custom transitions there. And then on the far right, we have all these percussion elements that we carved out, and they go into a separate system. Now this is really under the hood stuff. So this is actually the music scripting engine, custom made, that we've used at Naughty Dog for years. And I just wanna show you how this works. So this is how the chunks that are attached to the AI state work. And any non-interactive music in the game, any of the scripted, story-driven stuff is all scripted this way. So it's really simple, right? There's no pretty GUI here. It's just text-based, but it is super powerful. It's, that's the name of the cue. We've got the volume in there, and we can, this is a playlist. This is one playlist of chunks. So this is the stealth action chunks for the low intensity state in one of those setups. So the volume of each chunk is adjustable. We've got a loop counter. We know which layer they go on if we were to stack them up vertically, which we can do in this system. We're tracking tempo because we want everything to be beat synchronous. All our transitions are beat synchronous. Unless something happens that we want to trigger immediately, then we can override that. We've essentially got a time signature thing where we can say the number of beats per bar. And then this exit point, which I'm going to talk about a little later, but the exit point on a piece of music in this game became super, super important as we went along. And I'll tell you why in a little while. But that is the point at the end of the file where maybe there's a tail and it sounds good to start the next thing. And so typically that's a beat synchronous event, but not always.